Hey, what's happening, everybody? It's Andrew the Crafter, back at it again, and today I'll be showing you how to properly set up OBS Studios because I know that many people absolutely love OBS because it's a widely used application. And I'm going to show you properly how to actually upload the videos because I have tons of videos here that I always use, and sometimes they don't operate as properly as I'd like them to, so I'm going to show you how to, or my setup, how I always make sure that every single thing is proper and actually looks very nice. Like, you see how the mouse actually looks nice on the video. I don't know if it actually will or not. But instead of the gameplay, you always see that, yeah, the screen actually looks nice and it actually looks smooth. And the way that you specifically do that, I know I've been I looked for this setting for so long, but I know that there's tons of people who record at only 30 frames per second. Like, I don't know an example YouTuber, but actually personally, I used to go through and record with 30 FPS. So the way to actually fix said FPS here, if you're like me, who likes things to be a little bit high quality, the first thing you want to do is go into settings. You want to go to video here, and since I'm recording right now, you'll see I can't edit any of these things, but you can edit the resolution so your game can run faster if you're like that. The output resolution, which it's 1280 pixels by 720 pixels, and its aspect is 16:9, and the FPS value here, it'll give you an option. It'll start off with 30, and then it'll go up to 59 and I think 60. I don't remember all the values, but you'll always see that, and it is very important to always remember. And then there's this. I usually don't mess around with the audio. I usually just mess around with the audio like this. I do properties on here, or to mess around with the audio settings here. You always see the microphone aux, and you always have your desktop audio. But you can go through here and you can hit press properties, and you'll see here you'll have your microphones, however many you have. Me, I have a webcam. I have the headset that I always use, and the microphone that I'm using right now, the Yeti Nano. You'll always see. You'll probably see maybe one or two if you're like that. So I can just press OK on that. And then your desktop audio will always be something like this. It'll come up with tons of different things. So I have the Synapse program, Synapse 3.0 program running in the background. So if you do use Razer Synapse, then you'll see that, and you obviously have all your speakers here. But I don't know exactly how to get the Yeti Nano to display audio or have audio come out of it. That's a little bit weird. Anywho, yeah, I usually just set it to default. You can set it to whatever your audio you want your audio to actually have. So I can do the speakers. This is my headset here that I always use. I'm not using it right now because I'm recording with you guys. So the next thing you gotta do, if you want to stream, say for example, if you do want to stream, you go into settings and you'll see the general stream output, and you'll see audio, video, hotkeys, and whatever. the streaming here. You'll have the option to stream to Twitch, YouTube, Facebook Live, Restream, I don't know what that is, and Twitter. I've obviously record only on YouTube here, or YouTube Gaming. I don't know what YouTube Gaming is. I know that's obviously a part of YouTube, but I don't know what it actually is. The server, I don't think you really have to worry about that piece. But whenever you go to stream, say if you're going to go stream on an OBS with OBS here, and if I go to YouTube here, and if I go to go live, Then every single time you go to press the stream key, you'll see whatever. Okay. You'll probably find a stream key inside of here somewheres. But still, it's you'll put in the you'll put in the stream key inside of here, and there'll be the same exact instructions with the get stream key, and then you'll be able to put in the stream key, put on your title, your name, whatever the heck you want it to be. And that's how you would stream with OBS Studios. Now we're moving on to the output. This is probably one of the most important and probably one of the most stupidest things that you will ever have. Usually your YouTube will not accept, I don't remember what files it was, but you for every single time you go to recording, you'll see the recording format. This is probably one of the most important things you want to remember. You always want to put the recording format to be an MP4, so you can go through, so you can edit it instead of the Adobe Premiere Pro software or whatever software that you use, but always put it inside of the .MP4 file, because that there 100% saves you so much time whenever you're going to use the Handbrake application. I don't have it installed on this computer yet, but I always used to use that to get lower quality. No, not lower quality. No, smaller sized files. So it'll keep all like the frames and whatever. It'll have the same exact settings as the video, but yeah, it makes the video a lot smaller size and inside of, like, storage here. So yeah, you'll see I have a lot of space still. Anyways, continuing onwards with the hotkeys. The hotkeys is how people don't have their mouse like over here and then they just drag it onto the screen. I used to do that a lot, but now I do control F4. I know it's a joke, I know. I know if you press Alt F4, whoa, it closes out. So I just decided to do that as a joke. So the hotkey is how they work is that you can set it to a specific bind. Yeah. So if I do something like Control F, yeah, you have to hold down Control and then you could press something else. Except for you could just set it to a specific key or whatever. Whatever the heck you want it to be. So I'll set that back to Control 4. There we are. And then stop recording. Yeah. You get the correct idea. But this will allow you to stream quickly, stop stream, pause recording, unpause, stop, enable preview, studio mode. Studio mode, that's another thing I actually would like to do. No, I don't want to do that. The studio mode here is probably one of the cooler things. This here looks really, really, really nice. And this is exactly how we could do like the fade stuff, and this is pretty useful. It's very, very useful if you're going to do if you don't want to edit in like little shortcuts or whatever, or like cuts in between the video. I know that lots of Minecraft YouTubers do that, like they cut out specific set things, but studio modes used specifically for that. So it's very, very, very useful if you're trying to not edit as much. But I think other than the exit button and the sources, you obviously have your sources here, but if you're going to go record with OBS here and you're doing a gameplay here or something like that, you always want to do game capture. Number one reason on why that is because you can do different types of modes. Now, the one that you always want to do is capture a specific window. You can do. It'll show up with the application that you're running. Like, say I'm running the Minecraft game there, or Minecraft. It'll show up inside of here, like Minecraft.exe, and then yeah, you can put that as specifically that. Now, I am using the display capture right now. You see this? You can You see the red box here? That this here is outlining the exact screen that you're looking at right now. And that's exactly what you're seeing, which is OBS. Other than the thing, yeah, I know, right? Whoa, you can turn it off and on again. Whoa, spooky. Here, let me actually remove this. Yeah, the way that you remove it is there will be three buttons here and just press remove and get rid of it. Out of here. Me, I only have one. I just named it gameplay and then I can go through and do whatever. Anyways, I think that just about concludes it. I don't think you really need the scenes. I don't know exactly what that does. If you want me to do a scenes video, then I'll do it for you. Anyways, I hope you all enjoyed this little review of OBS Studios and how to work some of the things inside of here. And I guess I will see you later. See you guys. This is Andrew the Crafter signing off. Sayonara, everybody.